Sorry it's been so long, I've been really busy sort of sorting things out for my own sort of personal music, and I've joined a band and this, that and everything else. But I am back now with another sort of series. Hopefully we'll start this one off weekly, hoping to post it every Wednesday. What I'm going to be doing is reacting to the new releases that have come on the UK Top 40 every single week. You get my first reaction, my unedited complete reaction with opinions and whether I like it, whether I don't like it every week. This week we've got five new songs, then we've got some Post Malone, we've got some Hayley Steinfeld, then we've got some Molly Merz in there. Hopefully we'll have a look, we'll have a listen, we'll see through it, and I'll put in my reactions and see what you think. Hopefully we'll get this started, we'll sort of do it every sort of week, so hopefully you enjoy it. Thank you, it's good. Okay, so up first this week we've got the song Most Girls by Hayley Steinfeld. Now I can't say as I'm a big fan of any of this sort of pop music, but I'm going to give it a go, I'm going to give it a listen. I remember I've covered, I think it's Starving by Hayley Steinfeld, I've covered a few times, I quite often do that online, I've probably put a version on YouTube somewhere, but so yeah, this one is Most Girls by Hayley Steinfeld, let's see what we think. It's already that contemporary sort of pop sound, it's got that marimba going on in the background. It's that sort of typical contemporary dance sort of dun 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 dun. No. It's kind of got that shuffly feel to it as well. It's alright, I quite like this. Got sort of that punchy synth line underneath it, so sort of like a, like sort of goes like that sort of punching stabbing at the chords, it's quite nice. Kind of reminds me a little bit like Cold Water by Justin Bieber and Major Lazer last year. Not in the fact that it sounds like it, in the fact that the build to the chorus and then the launch into it, it just... And that sort of sampled vocal track going over the top of it. I mean, props to Hayley Steinfeld because there's no audio editing on her voice, like, as far as pitch correct goes at all, that I can tell. And the harmony's nice as well, but whether she, you know, arranged all that herself, I mean, I guess we don't know, but... It's one of them pop songs that you can kind of tell where it's going to go, so you can kind of see where it's going to build to and where it's this, that. It does really remind me of Cold Water by Major Lazer. That's cool, the sort of punch out and the, you know, the bass and the hand claps in it, that's really cool. Sort of like a choral vocal choir behind it, that's nice. I mean, for what it is, it's okay, but it's never going to be my cup of tea. It kind of just doesn't go anywhere for me. It's kind of too, you know, you can telegraph where the song is going to go instead of the song being quite, you know, where it changes up or, you know. I mean, like, it's never going to be Pink Floyd-esque, but it is, you know, it's never going to be anything overly, you know, introverted, but... For what it is, I mean, it's a good song, it's alright, it's never going to be my type of thing. I can see why it's in the top 40, it's very contemporary sounding, but for me, it's not really for me, you know, don't dislike it, but I'll probably listen to it this one time and then never really listen to it again. So yeah, that's that one, let's move on to the next one. Okay, so up next we've got the song Congratulations by Post Malone featuring Quavo, I think it's pronounced. Like I say, not a clue, I don't listen to any of this sort of music, so we'll launch straight into it, we'll just have a listen. I mean... You know, it's really not my cup of tea at all. I'll try and put it out and just listen to it for what it is, but to me it already sounds like every song that's ever been written like this about, you know, people that enjoy smoking weed and wearing fucking big necklaces, but hey, you know, get on with it if that's your bag. I mean, I might be in the minority, but I can't really understand what he's saying. Like, I don't know whether that's just me or whether, like, a lot of people have that problem with this guy, because I don't know, I've never heard a song of his before. So. I mean, I don't know what the music video is about. Maybe I should just do a reaction to the music video, because the music video itself is really weird. It's that typical sort of, like, you know, where they jar the vocal line up, so it's like, you know. And as far as the video goes, I mean, I know I'm talking about the songs themselves, but the video, it's not good, really. I mean, there's a guy smashing up a TV with a baseball bat. Like, I presume that's Post Malone. I mean, it's kind of got that, like, catchy melody bit to it. Not really a melody, but like an ostinato thing, like the congratulations, but, like... So far, that's probably one of maybe five words that I've actually understood him saying, so... I mean, they're blurring out all the logos and video to the songs. Like, if you can't use the product in your songs, like, don't put them in. So they're just blurring them out. It just looks stupid. I mean, it's just another rapper talking about his cars and his jewellery. Like, it's... like, congratulations, you've gotten cars and jewellery. Like, I really don't care. I mean, like, it's really sort of clutching at straws, trying to make the known rhyme with gone. Like, I know I can't talk. Some of the songs I've written, I've really tried to stretch some of the rhymes, but, you know, moan and gone, that's completely, you know, that's just wrong. No, this song's really not for me, so... I'm sorry if that's your bag, but, you know, I can safely say, whereas the last one, you know, I may listen to again if it comes on. I definitely will turn it off if it comes on, that one. I think I'll see the name Post Malone and forever be haunted, because I'm really not a fan of that one. So, anyways, each to their own. Let's move on to the next song. Okay, so up next we've got Ollie Murs and Louisa Johnson with Unpredictable. You know, I'm an 18-year-old lad with a mum that's in her early 40s. So I've heard Ollie Murs before, you know, she used to play in the car all the time, but, you know, whatever. I guess I was more into it when I was a bit younger, when he first came about, than I would be now, per se, but, you know, he's got a few good songs out there. Hopefully this one's as good as some of the other ones. You know, I remember, you know, Thinking of Me was quite cool, and the one he did with Flo Rida, Troublemaker, was quite cool. So hopefully this one's another good one. Really like the one he did with Demi Lovato as well. So hopefully Unpredictable, this one should be good. I mean, again, the same with Hailee Steinfeld's song, it's got everything that makes me sort of... everything that makes it that contemporary sounding pop song, which means, you know, I can understand what's in the chart at the moment. Again, it's got that sort of shuffle to it, but the melody this time is, you know, it's more catchy and, you know, you can get into this one a bit more, whereas that last fucking heap of shit with Post Malone, you know, whatever, this one, I can see why this one would be in the chart, because this one's a good song. You know, props to Ollie Murs as well. You know, he's one of them people that sort of broke out of that whole, you know, oh, he did well on the X Factor thing. He's kind of made a name for himself outside of that now completely. And, you know, this one, as I can see, it's, you know, if it's not broken, don't fix it. And it is still very Ollie Murs. He's just moving with the times in the sense that, you know, that shuffle's in there and the contemporary sort of sweeping off to the choruses are in there. You know, it's, you know, no problems with this at all. This one's good. It's got a cool little bass line underneath as well. Quite low in the mix, I'd turn that up a bit if I was producing it, but it's quite a cool little, you know, bass line. I imagine there'll be some really cool remixes of this coming out as well. I might have to have a listen to a few of them. And again, you know, the typical, you know, 2017 song, I've got a video coming out about that in the next few days, but where you do the vocal imitates what the synths are doing, so you've kind of got like the melody in two different instruments, like, which, you know, whatever. But no, you know, it's a good song. It does just remind me of Ollie Murs, which I suppose is a good thing because it is an Ollie Murs song. That's what you'd want. I mean, yeah. You know, I quite like that. You know, no problems with that one at all. You know, it's very generic. It's your sort of typical pop song. Again, like I said with Hayley Steinfeld, you can see where it's going to go. It's very structured, very formulaic. But, you know, cool. If that's your bag, then that's your bag. Then get on with it. I don't see a problem with it. So let's go on to the second to last song of this episode. Okay, so the next song we've got is a song called Chasing Highs by Alma. I've never heard of Alma. I presume she's got a new artist that doesn't seem to have... You know, it's got a fair few hits on YouTube, obviously, as you can expect, but, you know, for an artist that puts a song out quite recently, it's not that many. But let's take a listen and see what we think. I've no idea what to expect on this one. So. It's that marimba again straight away. I mean, it kind of sounds like I've heard it before. You know, so far there's nothing really that I feel like I haven't heard, you know, in the chart in the last year. Like that sort of, like that sort of cackly, I don't like that at all. It sounds like the kid laughing on The Simpsons, I don't like that. I mean, still, you know, it's not taking me anywhere, it's not particularly exciting, it's just, you know, whatever, it's your typical 2017 pop song. I really don't like that. That's bordering on horrific, that's not good at all. What is it with baseball bats and music videos at the moment? I mean, yeah, if that's your bag, then cool. But, you know, I'm not really... I'm not a fan of that one at all, really. You know, whatever, don't hate it, but I don't like it at all. You know, it's just, what, again, I probably won't listen to that one ever again, really, so... You know, and that laugh bit, what sort of laugh? Not a laugh, it sounds like a laugh, sounds like a cackle. But whatever that bit is done, you know, that bit needs to be dubbed out of that song, because that really, you know, that puts the song in a really different light. But anyways, let's move on to the next one, which I think is by Rudimental. Okay, so the last track we've got this week is by Rudimental, so called Sun Comes Up, featuring James Arthur, so already. You know, I think this one, not so sure about Rudimental, never really liked much of their stuff, but James Arthur, I'm a big fan. So, hopefully Rudimental can kind of merge into sort of James Arthur's thing whilst keeping what they've got, because hopefully, who knows, it could be really good. Let's have a listen. I mean, yeah, so far it's quite good. I mean, not bad at all. I mean, they put this out at the exact right time. This is going to be like a big song for the summer in the UK, I can see already, you know. It's a very contemporary summer song. This is one of the rare exceptions as well where I don't feel like the marimba and the steel drums are just overkilling it, because, you know, that's what everybody's doing at the moment. You know, this song, I think the steel drums and the marimbas are adding something to this. It's kind of giving that vibe, like, you know, a bit more. Because, like, the steel drums are slightly different from anything else. There's not really many of them that come about at the moment. So that's kind of giving it that edge on everything else. I think the drum machine's a little bit complicated. I think it could have been done with just being, you know, held back a bit. But, you know. I like the contrast as well, you know, between this bit and the bits that have come before it and what I'm assuming is going to come after it. But, like, sort of the build back up to it, you know, it's cool, it sounds good. And I like that James Arthur's holding his voice back as well, because I know in a lot of his songs, sometimes the issue is that he doesn't, he kind of, you know, he really goes for it, which is beautiful in its own right, but in some of his songs it doesn't need it. And this is one of them songs where it doesn't need it at all, because it's just, he's killing it, just singing as, you know, comfortable as you'd say. I really enjoyed that. That one was really good. If anything, I think that one's my favourite. I think that one's the highest one of the five in the chart at the moment as well. I think that's sort of like the mid-teens. So, yeah, I really like that one actually. I can see that one doing, you know, a fair amount with it being, you know, just coming into the UK summertime and, you know, the UK club scene's crying out for a song like that at the moment. So, yeah, no, that one out of the five is probably my favourite song. Okay, everybody, thank you for watching. Like I say, it's been a bit of a rough one, this one. Just kind of getting to grips with the whole concept of it. You know, we've had the five songs, we've had Rudimental, is it Alma, we've had Post Malone, which I will never ever listen to again, Ollie Mears, and we've had Hayley Steinfeld. The Rudimental one with James Arthur, by far my favourite, and that's a very, very good track, and the Post Malone being, you know, by far my least favourite, by quite a way actually. That's really not my vibe at all. I feel like I've kind of just shout all over that song, but hey, I'm sure there's plenty of people out there that have said the complete opposite. I'm sure not many people will take my opinion as gospel anyway, if any, really. So, yeah. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you've enjoyed the video, then drop me a like, give me a share, leave a comment with any suggestions for this sort of series as well. Hopefully we're going to try and get a few more people on board. We're going to try and get, you know, sort of joint reactions to this sort of thing. Hopefully get a few people to come down and sit and react with me. But yeah, if you've enjoyed it, like I say, leave a like, drop a comment on some suggestions. All my social media in the description, you can enjoy all that as well. I've been Aaron, thank you very much for watching. See you later.